when the width of the line is minus 1, and here the width of the line is plus 1. Now I want to ask you a question. In this y-axis here represents the variation in S22. How many dB changes in S22 in the response? In this case, when we have the resistor R1, the x-axis, all the way to plus 1, that change in S22 is about 1, 2, 3, 4, 4.5 dB. Okay, so the interaction is giving 4.5 dB extra added variation to our S22 just due to the interaction between the resistor R1 and the width of the lines. 4.5 dB variation. But notice in this side, if I go to the resistor low to minus 1, that variation in S22 due to the interaction is reduced to less than 2 dB. Now, as a designer, where would you like to be? Would you like to be in this area where you have an added 4.5 dB? When I say added, because you have other variations from other elements. This is only the interactions that are causing this variation. Would you like to be in this 4.5 dB variation in S22, or would you like to be in this area where it's less than 2 dB variation? I would choose this area. I cannot control the width of the lines due to process variation. But what I can control is the resistor. I can control the resistor variation, and I can also reduce the value of that resistor. What is really this telling me is if I reduce the value of this resistor from 20 ohm to 18 ohm, for example, and on top of this, if I control the resistor variation by making it fat resistor instead of skinny to reduce the sensitivity, I can reduce that S22 variation and I can be here. Okay, this is a very simple example of the interaction plot. As I mentioned before, some designs, you might find that the interactions between two elements is huge. It is causing major problems in the design. This is why the interaction plots are very useful and very beneficial for the designers, so they can fix their design before proceeding. Now let me go back to my design, and let me open another design. This is another design of experiment example that I would like to share with you. Notice here now, in this experiment, I am running a design of experiment on matching networks. And the way I did this, all the components in the input matching network, as shown here, all the components in this matching network, I represent them or I steer them in the same direction, put some variation to it with a variable X. So I have X, Y, Z. The X represent the input matching network, Y represent the middle stage, and Z represents the output matching network. So this DOE experiment is really done not on three variables, it is done on three matching networks. So if you have a design that has all kinds of matching networks, you know, like let's say four-stage amplifier, then you can run a DOE experiment, design of experiments, on just the matching networks. And design of experiments will tell you, hey, the interstage matching network between FET number 2 and FET number 3 is what's causing the problem in your design. Then you can go ahead and change that interstage matching network and solve the problem. So this is really useful on matching networks, not on components only. So if I go ahead right now and hit simulate, it will again run the experiment on the three matching networks, not the three components. And notice because I have now three elements, I run 8 experiments. 2^3 is 8 experiments. Okay, let me open the data display. Okay, and here's the data display for the three elements I have. Let's study them. Let's first look at the Pareto chart for the gain. This is telling me that 96% of the gain variation is caused by the middle section. You remember I have three matching networks, the input, followed by the FET structure, followed by the output matching network. The FET structure is the Y. You remember X, Y, Z? So the Y, the FET structure, which has the resistor R1, if you remember, is causing 95% of my gain variation. And the input matching network, the whole input matching network, is only causing 1 or 2% of the gain variation. So I learned something now, that my middle section, my middle matching network that has the resistor R1, is causing the gain variation here. And again, I want to see how much gain variation is that. And I look here and I find out that the resistor is causing about 0.3 dB variation in the gain. Okay, now let's look at this noise figure spec. This Pareto chart here for the noise figure is telling me that, believe it or not, you might expect that the noise figure variation is coming from the input matching network, right? The input matching network in general is the main sensitive section for noise figure. But look at this. This is telling me that 95% of my noise figure variation is caused again by the middle section, by that FET and the resistor R1, not by the input matching network. The input matching network is causing the noise figure to change only like 2%. Let's see the effect plots to see how much is that change. And again, we see that it is very, very small. It is 0.01 or 0.015 dB change due to that resistor R1. Okay, now we look at the S22 spec, and we notice that the Z, which is the output matching network, is causing 90% of the variation in S22, which is expected, right? Output matching network, output S22, you know, the S22. So 90% of the variation in S22 is coming from that Z section, which is the output matching network. We notice here it goes from minus 2 to minus 8, which is about 6 dB change in S22 due to that output matching network. So in this example, basically I showed you how matching networks, DOE, can be used on matching networks. This and this and this. And again, if you have an amplifier or any design that has like maybe 20 matching networks different. Maybe you have a macro cell that has an amplifier followed by a mixer followed by another amplifier, an LO amp, you know, to drive the mixer. You have many matching networks. You could run a design of experiment on all the matching networks. Let's say you have 10 matching networks. You run 2 to the 10 experiment, and ADS does them really fast for you. So you find out which matching network is causing the yield problem. And once you find this yield matching, the yield problem is caused by, let's say, one matching network, man, it's just like an X-ray machine. You can concentrate and you can focus on that matching network and fix it. And the yield problem will be eliminated. All the variation will be eliminated. This is a great tool to use. It's very, very useful. Thank you for watching this design of experiment presentation, and we do have in ADS, we do have an example in the examples directory, microwave circuits. We have a mimic example that has all these design files and all these simulation setups and results. I encourage you to go and open this example file and just hit simulate and watch the data display and learn more how to use it. It's a very useful tool. Thank you for watching.